And thanks all of you for coming. Shiram and I work on making the web fast at Google, just like most of you here do. But the web is actually not really fast. It takes 5 seconds on average to load a web page today, and that's a long time. Over the past few years, all of us have worked very hard to make the web faster. There's been significant technical innovation across the entire ecosystem of the web. I mean, the browsers have gotten way faster than what they used to be before. There's been incredible research in improving the core network protocols like TCP and SSL, and also the web standards in general, to make them speed-friendly. There's been an explosion in the tools available to developers to measure how fast their service is, and also, you know, what is actually making their pages slow. I mean, we saw a bunch of them just now. You know, there's so much of that. And not only that, I mean, there are also optimizers available today, like Mod Page Speed, which you can just deploy on your website, and it just makes your pages fast automatically. That's all great. Not only that, I mean, the hardware keeps getting faster. You know, every year we have new machines that are faster than the year before. The physical infrastructure is improving. Today, on fiber, you can transmit terabits of data per second, like just on a single strand. I mean, that's, you know, that's amazing. The home connection speeds have gotten better. You know, it's very normal to have 10 megabits per second DSL connection at your home. I mean, we're not satisfied with that. I mean, we actually would like that to be 1 gigabits per second, you know, which is the goal of our, you know, fiber to the home experiment that we are trying out in the Kansas City. So that's all great. I mean, there's been, you know, amazing progress in you know, as far as technology is concerned, but the web is still not instant. How do we, you know, it's not as fast as flipping a page of a magazine or flipping a TV channel, and that's what we actually want it to be. You go click on a web page and it should be right there. So how do we do that? How do we make the web instant? One thing that we haven't seen covered as much is that we, you know, as humans, you know, we're not as fast as computers. When browsing, it takes us time to make up our mind on what page we want to visit next. And even once we've made up our mind that, you know, this is the page that I want to go to, it actually takes a lot of time to, you know, just do that click on the link to actually see the page. In fact, you know, Shiram will show you, you know, we have a you know, quick web page here which shows, you know, how long it takes to actually just do a click.
All right. So what we have here is a very simple JavaScript-based test page. This is a link here that says click here, so I'm going to naturally click that. But it's going to dance around the page. So I'm going to try and chase that link and click on it. And we're going to measure how long it takes for me to do that. We're not actually going to measure how long it takes for me to find the link. We're only going to start measuring from the moment my mouse is already on top of the link, what we call the on mouse over, right? So the hover time is what is being measured. That is from the time it takes for the mouse to be on the link to the time that it takes for me to complete the click. So think about it, right? So and you will see the average time recorded over here in the top left, so let me do that. So I'm trying to click it as fast as I can. I'm not trying to be particularly slow just to, you know, make the demo more impressive. But you can see that despite my best efforts, from the time the mouse is already on the link to the time that I finish clicking the link is roughly around 300 milliseconds, right? This is actually a fast day for me. Usually I'm a lot slower than this. Right. Yeah. Now, think about this for a second. The user has already signaled their very strong intent to click a link because the mouse is already there on top of the link, right? But there is still significant time, upwards of 300 milliseconds, for you to do something during that time. You already know the user wants to click the link, and you have some time. Don't waste it. Do something with it. You know, go open a network connection, fetch some resource, update some state on the page.
So consider Google Search. Last year, we launched Google Instant. Google Instant leverages the time when the user is actually thinking about what query he wants to actually enter on Google. And it guesses and shows you the result before you even complete typing your query. I mean, that's an example of how we can use the time when the user actually thinks to do something that he needs. But even on Google Search, you know, the story is not complete yet. Once we show the results page, it takes, on average, 15 seconds for a user to just select and click on result. That's a really long time. So if you could predict which result the user would click on, we could start fetching that before the user actually clicks on the result. And you know, that's good news because you know, often we actually know with high likelihood which result the user would click on. So this is what we implemented in Google Search. You know, this is a combination of technology on Google Search as well as a new technology in Chrome called pre-rendering. It's called Instant Pages, and we announced it day before yesterday, and it's quite cool. Take a look if you haven't already.
All right, so this is a video demo. I'm not going to actually click anything over here. What you're going to see is Google Search, regular Google Search on the left side, and Google Search with Instant Pages, which was announced 2 days ago, on the right side. The actions are mirrored, so whatever happens on the left side, you know, searches, clicks, happen on the right side as well, and you can see how long it takes for pages to load. Very briefly, the right side is going to be much faster because it preloads, it predicts what link you want to click and preloads that link. Okay, so here we go. We have some music to go along with it.
All right, so that's really fast. What's happening there is once a user does a search, if he's likely to click on a result, we start loading that page in a hidden tab in the browser. And when the user actually clicks on the result, we just replace the current tab with that hidden tab. And it's instantaneous, you know, as you saw it. It sounds pretty simple, but there are quite a few technical challenges that we had to actually solve to, you know, make it all work. For example, just think about a page that has blaring audio or video on it. And we don't want hidden tabs to actually make sounds. So there's a lot of, you know, technical challenges like those that we actually solve, you know, as part of this pre-rendering technology in Chrome. So that's all great. But you know, so we are able to actually make our search interaction and, you know, the tasks that we're actually trying to accomplish on Google, you know, pretty fast using it. But that's only a small fraction of what we do on the web. We visit web pages through a variety of other ways. Sometimes we enter URLs in the address bar manually. Sometimes we load a URL from a bookmark. And most of the times, we're actually just clicking on links from the page that we are currently on. And in all of those cases, there is this opportunity. You know, there's a lot of time when the user is actually thinking, and we could actually make use of that time to make things really, really fast for the user. In fact, in Chrome, we have this experimental feature called Chrome Instant, which you can enable. And what that does is that as you're typing in a URL in the address bar, it tries to predict what page you actually want to go to. And if its prediction is strong, then it actually just loads that page right in front of you. In fact, we'll just see that as well.
All right. The third and last demo for this. So this is Chrome. And as Arvind mentioned, if you go to preferences, in the very basics, you will see a link, a checkbox here that says enable instant for faster searching and browsing. So you've got that turned on. So now you just have to type something in the address bar. Chrome is going to preload the stuff that you're looking for and show you a preview right away. So I'm going to type, I want to go to CNN, so I'm going to type, well, I have to focus the address bar first. So, all right. It's, you know, you don't even have to complete typing the URL. Chrome shows you autocomplete suggestions, and it takes the first suggestion and goes and preloads and previews it. For the purposes of this demo, I'm not going to click on the top story, right? I'm going to do something else. So you know, let's say I wanted to do a search for Costco photo. There you go. So the top autocomplete suggestion happens to be a suggestion for a search, and that's what gets previewed.
There's a lot of work that needs to be done here. So, you know, it'll be time, you know, sometime before we actually make it a default. But I mean, there's a limit to, you know, a limit to which a browser can actually predict what the user actually needs. In many cases, the author of the page actually knows more. You know, author of the page knows what the user would need next, you know, when they are on a particular page. So we need to make sure that this technology is as easily available and can be used by page authors as we're using it today in Google Search. And that's how we implemented this feature. It's actually quite simple, and it's available to everyone. All the page author has to do is embed a link rel pre-render as a new tag in their page, and you know, they can use this to instruct the browser to load a page that the user is likely to visit next. So you should all use this feature, but you know, use it carefully. You know, there are actually, you know, obviously downsides to preloading. You know, if you actually get it wrong, obviously if the user doesn't visit that page that you preloaded, then we wasted a bunch of resources both on the client and the server as well as network bandwidth. So we need to be careful. But in general, you know, it's okay. You know, it's okay to actually get this really large benefit for the users, you know, at the cost of occasional misprodictions. And that's, you know, that's nothing new. You know, it's actually very common practice in computing. Even the CPUs predict the instructions that, you know, they're likely to actually execute, and they deal with misprediction at times. There are more challenges. Preloading can actually make it difficult for ad networks and analytics software to actually do proper accounting. Because, I mean, there are cases when you preload a page, but the user never actually visited it. So how do we make sure that we don't inflate page view counts and things like those? And that's where the page visibility API comes in. We've actually proposed a new standard to W3C. It's called page visibility API. It allows the developer to determine whether a page is in this pre-rendering state, you know, the state where it's actually loading, all the JavaScript is getting executed, but the page is not visible to the user. And then, you know, the API can also be used to figure out when the page was actually made available to the user. So, you know, ads and analytics software can make use of that API to actually do proper accounting. And it's actually better than that because, you know, today itself, accounting is broken. For example, if you middle click on a link and it goes into a background tab, today ad software and analytics software actually get it wrong. If you end up never seeing that page, they will still think that you saw it. So that's our solution to actually handle the problem of ads and analytic counting. So that's really all. You know, we have made, you know, tried to make this technology as easy as possible for all page authors to use. It's implemented in Chrome today, but it's open source, and we hope that all the other browser vendors will also implement this in future, and you know, thereby making the web instant for all of us. That's all for today. Thank you so much. And if you have any questions.